Welcome back to the channel, and today I'm going to show you how to get your Oculus Quest set up with Sidequest. So Sidequest is a third-party app store that has a ton of games on them that you can't get through the official Oculus Quest store. These games are also typically free, so it could save you a ton of money, so it's certainly worth you sticking around to find out how to do this. I'm going to show you 5 easy steps of how to get set up, hopefully you can do it in about 3 minutes, and then the process of getting the games onto the Quest after that is really easy. So let's get into it. So before we go any further, if you'd rather look at an in-depth review of the Oculus Quest, then click my card up above and that'll take you to my in-depth review. If however you like this video, then please don't forget to like and share. Also subscribe to my channel using the buttons down below and hit that notification bell so you're notified about new videos as and when I post them. It is worth pointing out with the Sidequest app store that it is an unofficial app store, and as such, you do need to be a little bit careful of the games that you sideload onto your Oculus Quest. Pay attention to the comments and the star ratings of the games themselves, and you'll be in pretty safe hands. There are some really good games in there from some really good development houses, the likes of Pavlov, Hyperdash, Contractors, are really just naming 3 in that list, and that list is forever growing bigger. So let's get going with the 5 easy steps needed to get your Oculus Quest set up. Now, as well as the video, I'm going to put all the step descriptions in the description down below, so you can always refer to those if you need to go back and forth. Also, if you have any problems with any of the steps and need some help, again, put some comments down below and I'll help out where I can. Let's get onto it with step 1. So the first thing we need to be doing is set up your Oculus account as a developer account. So in order to do that, you need to go to the dashboard.oculus.com website. First time you log in, it'll ask you to set up an organization name. Put in whatever name, select I understand, click next. You'll have some agreement disclosure that you need to agree to. Just agree to that, and that will go and set up your organization. That's that step now done. So the next thing we want to be doing is installing the ADB drivers. So you only need to do this if you've got a Windows PC. If you're doing this on a Mac or a Linux machine, you don't need to do it. For Windows, this is what allows you to transfer the games from your PC to your Oculus Quest once you've got everything set up. So for this, you need to go to the developer.oculus.com website. Again, log in with the credentials for your Oculus account. You have to accept on I read and agree to the agreements, and then click on download. Downloads pretty quickly. Again, bottom left of the screen, click on that, say show in folder. I'm going to right click on that and say extract all. And then just select the default folder, or you can put it somewhere else if you like. Now you can go into the folder, so double click, and then go into the USB driver folder. In there is a winusb.inf file. Just right click on that and click on install, select on OK. It's also worth pointing out that you might get a UAC pop-up warning in Windows. You just want to accept that warning, and that'll allow you to install that file. When it's finished, it will come up and say operation successful. And that's that step done. So the next thing we're going to need to do is activate developer mode on your Oculus Quest itself. Now for that, we're going to need the help of the Oculus Quest app that's on your phone. So log into the Oculus Quest app and also make sure that your Oculus Quest is on and it's on the same network as your mobile phone. Once that's all set up, go into the settings of the app, click on the Oculus Quest once it's connected, click on settings and developer mode. Turn developer mode on. Now go back into the developer settings and click on the unlock pattern. You'll make sure the unlock pattern is off. So if you've got it set on, disable it. Once that's all done, make sure you restart your Oculus Quest itself just to ensure that those new settings take hold on the Oculus Quest. So now we need to go and install Sidequest itself. So go to the website, go to sidequestvr.com. And go to the Get Sidequest button at the top. That will show you the 3 different options. So for Windows, Mac OS or Linux, click on whichever one you need to install and your browser will start downloading it. Again, it's on the bottom left-hand side of the browser here. Once it's loaded, go down with your mouse icon and just click on that file and it will automatically start installing Sidequest. It will ask you whether you want to do it for all users or just yourself. I select everybody. And just use the default folder, but you can change it if you like. That will now go and install Sidequest. By default, it will run Sidequest when it finishes. So we'll just leave it like that and click on finish. The first time you get into Sidequest, this is your landing page. Now you need to sign into the Sidequest app. So top right, click on the sign in button. Now, if you've already got a Sidequest account, you can just log in using this page here. If not, you need to click on the sign up button next to it on the left-hand side, enter all of your credentials for setting up your account, and click the sign up button on the right-hand side. And that's it. You're now logged in. This is the homepage you'll see, and you are now logged into Sidequest and ready to go to start downloading the games from here to your Oculus Quest. So now we need to connect the Oculus Quest to the computer. So with Sidequest still open, on the top left-hand side, you'll notice it says not connected. So plug the USB cable into your Oculus Quest and the PC, and it will say on the top left-hand side, unauthorized allowing headset. What you need to do is go into your Oculus Quest, so put it on, and you will see a permission pop up saying please allow. So just click on that and say allow, and then in the Sidequest, the top left-hand side, you will notice that it will eventually turn around and turn into a green dot and give you the IP address of the Oculus Quest. We are now all set up and ready to go to start using Oculus Quest with Sidequest. Now on the landing page, you can only see about 15 games, and there's no obvious place where you can actually get to the main library. It's actually hidden in the button or the logo at the top left-hand side of the page. So click on that Sidequest button or the Sidequest logo, and it will take you to the main page. Now you can see all the games that you actually want to go and look at. You can browse through it by genre or most popular. So if we just click on Hyper Dash here, it will then take you to the Hyper Dash main page. There's a demo normally of what the game looks like, a description and everything else. And up in the top right, you'll see an install to headset option. If you click on that, that will start the process of installing the file to your Oculus Quest. So on the bottom, it will say installing app. And then when that's finished, it will say install finished. So now if you go to the headset, it places them in an unknown sources folder. So if you go to your normal library, there's a drop down that allows you to select various filters. And by default, it's set to all. In that drop down, you want to change it to unknown sources. That will now show you all of the files that you've downloaded from the Sidequest onto your device. So here you can see Hyper Dash. So we're just going to click on that, and it's now loaded the game. So you've just got your first game from Sidequest on your Oculus Quest.
And that's it, your Oculus Quest should now be set up and ready to go for Sidequest. You've got your first game downloaded onto it. So now it's up to you to go into the App Store and start trying out those games. If you had any problems following any of the steps previously, comment down below. Let me know if you've got any issues, I'll try and help you out. Also, let me know how you do with any of the games. Any you loved, any you hated. Again, put them down in the comments. Helps everybody else out to understand and see what they should be trying as well. Till next time.